In terms of game development, I am a total beginner. I know some of the basics of Unity. Rider holds no secrets for me, so I'm wondering, can I script a Unity game with AI assistants? If you think I can, like this video and subscribe to our channel for more of these videos. Now, let's hit play. I already prepared an empty Unity 3D project with one modification. I downloaded two different assets that I can use in the game to visualize things later on. So I have brick figures and I have bricks that I can use on the scene. And with that, let's see if we can code a game. So what I'm going to do first is create a new empty game object, and I'm going to call that one main. And this empty main game object will be the one that controls the entire game. To control the game, I'm going to add a new component, a new script, and I will call that one game controller. That game controller is now being added to my assets. It's linked up to the empty game object. So let's see if we can open this one up in Rider. In Rider, I already configured AI Assistant. You will need a subscription for that or use the free trial. But with that, we can just start coding using the AI Assistant. The start method here is the method that I will use to start generating the game scene that I have in my game. So what I want to do is create a grid that is aligned on the X and the Z axis, and that will use one of the prefabs that I downloaded earlier from the asset store. So what I'm going to do in the start method, I'm going to Alt Enter, use the AI actions, and then generate codes. The prompt I have here is very specific. I will read it to you. I just pasted it because it's very long and I don't want you to see me typing. But it's generate a 5x5 grid on the X and Z axis containing the grid element prefab with a 1.1 distance between each element. Scale the grid element prefab to 0.5 by 0.5 and color the grid element prefab red, blue, green, yellow, or gray randomly. Let's execute that one and see what the AI assistant makes of it. So it's already creating a field to hold my grid element prefab. It's setting the spacing in a private variable, so that's also quite useful, and then adding everything to my grid. This looks pretty much okay, so let's accept all of the changes that we have here, save, and go back into the Unity editor. Now my main game object now has a link to link a grid element prefab, and what I'm going to do is search the assets that I have in my project for a 2x2 brick to use there. Let's switch into game mode and see if we have a grid. And yes, we have. We have a grid that is generated by code, and I didn't even have to type a line of code. So that's pretty cool, I think. The next thing I want to do is add a player prefab and an enemy prefab. So what I want to do is on that grid locate a player that I can move around using the arrow keys, and then have an enemy that tries to catch that player. So what I'm going to do is simply copy this one, make that player prefab, and make this one enemy prefab. Save that, go back into Unity and just hook things up so I can visualize everything that I have there. So for my player prefab, I'm going to use a green block figure that I downloaded as an asset. So let's go with that one. And for my enemy, I will search for a red one that I know is in there and use that one. Back into Rider. So what I want to do is add that player at the center of the grid. So let's see if we can prompt that using AI Assistant. Now, previously, I used the Alt-Enter shortcut to do that, but you can also write comments, and then Rider will try its best to infer the prompt from that comment and do something with it. So what we're going to do is say that we want to create a player from player prefab at the 3x3 position of the grid. That should be the center. Let's see if AI Assistant can do something with that. Yes, it can, and it's adding something to my grid. Nice. Let's do the same thing with the enemy. Create an enemy from the enemy prefab at the edge of the grid. That looks like a cool prompt, so let's use that. And that also looks nice. It's placing it at position 000, which should be the edge, at least one edge of the grid that we have there. Now, just to keep track of the player that I want to use later on to move it around and everything, I am going to create a new field for that. So I'm typing some code myself, and I'm going to use the same thing or going to do the same thing with the enemy. Now, player is not yet a field, but I can alt enter and then create a field from that using Rider functionality and be done with it. And I can do the same thing with the enemy here, create a field and keep track of the enemy in there. All right, just to see if this works, I'm going to switch back into play mode and see if I now have a player and an enemy on the grid, and apparently I have, so thank you AI for doing this, cool. Now back into the editor, I also want to move the camera a little bit. So now the camera was somewhere in the back of the grid, and ideally I want to have like a top-down view of the entire grid so I can see what is going on in the game. So what I'm going to do is again, instruct AI Assistant to do that and say, move the camera so that it shows the entire grid from the top. Let's go with that. We get some code there. I have no idea if this works. We'll find out later, but let's go with this one for now. Now, one thing we want to do is move the player around, and that can be done in the update function. So for every frame, the update function is called in Unity. So what we're going to do here is see if the AI assistant can help us to make sure that the player can actually move around on the grid when we are using keyboard shortcuts. So again, I'm going to use prompting inline here using comments. I'm going to say move player to the grid element in front of it when the arrow up key is pressed. Now, very important, I also want to make sure that we do not move out of the last grid element, just to make sure that we stay in the boundary of the grid that we created. AI Assistant is thinking, it apparently generated something already, so I can just tap and look at the code there. And to be fair, this looks reasonably okay. We are getting the current player position. If it's smaller than 4, which is the grid size that we have, 0 based, then we are going to move it around based on the key that we have. Now, an interesting thing is that when prompting from comments, if you go to the next line, AI Assistant may give you some hints about other functionality that you want to add. And it detects that we're using arrow up key, down key, we are in a Unity project. So apparently it inferred that we are trying to build a game. And you will see that there's now a prompt that says move the player to the grid element behind it when the down key is pressed, and do not move out of the first grid element, which is quite interesting. So let's tab and let's go with that. Now, hopefully AI Assistant will also generate a left and right function. And apparently we do get a left function and we get a right function in one go. So that's pretty interesting. Let's switch back into Unity and see if this actually works. So the first thing you will see is that the camera is now top down, so that worked. And if I press the keys, we are essentially seeing the player move around, which is also quite interesting. Nice. Again, thank you, AI Assistant. The last thing I want to add in the game, or at least one of the last things that I want to add in the game, is the ability for the enemy to catch up with the player that we have. So we're going to try to catch the player so that the player will have to escape the enemy that we have there. So what we can do there is use coroutines in Unity, and I'm going to prompt saying start a coroutine to move the enemy to the player. That's going to be generated using AI Assistant, which is nice, except that that move enemy method is nowhere to be seen. So what I'm going to do is use Alt Enter, create that method in Rider, and just go with IEnumerator. Now, an interesting thing happens. This throw new system not implemented exception line has the AI Assistant icon right next to it, which means that I can Alt Enter. And the first thing that you see in the menu there is that I can implement this method using AI Assistant. So let's see if that works. You will see that AI Assistant opens up a chat and will try to come up with some code and an explanation of what that code will be doing. It gets the context of the fact that we are in a Unity project. It gets the context of the player and the enemy being there. And based on that, it's going to do something. This looks cool, so I'm going to go with that. I'm going to select the method that we have there, and I'm just going to click replace this one, and move it in. That's pretty nice. Going to close this window, go back into the Unity editor, and see if the enemy is actually trying to catch up with the player that we have. And yes, it's very fast apparently, which is not what we want. So maybe we want to change the speed there a little bit. But we can do that using the speed that we have here, and let's divide it by 100 and see if that works better. We'll do that one later on. The final thing that I want to add in the code here is to also make it so that when the enemy comes very close to the player, essentially intersects with the player, I want to make sure that the player position resets to the center of the grid, or at least the initial starting position, so that later on we can even add some scoring functionality, etc. So I can do that in the update methods, and what I'm going to do is add another prompt and say if the enemy is within 0.5 from the player, reset the player position. Now I know this is not very specific, but ideally AI Assistant is going to infer that the original position was position 3 and 3, and it is actually applying that one, so this should work. Let's go back into Unity, go back into play mode, and see if this all works or not. So the enemy is now moving. It is indeed slower. I can still move my player. The enemy is changing direction. And when the enemy catches up with the player, which is going to happen, yes, the player position resets to where it originally started. So I would say our game is right now, it is complete, and we can ship it and probably expand on it and so on. Now, if you go back into Rider, you will see that there's other AI functionality that you can invoke. If you go with the Alt-Enter menu, AI Actions, you will also see that there's the Explain Code functionality. This one is super interesting because maybe you don't remember what you did, or you want to have a quick summary of what you have been doing while you were generating the code for this game. So what you can do is explain codes. This will open the AI Assistant chat again, and you can just see what has been going on, and the AI Assistant is going to try and explain what you have been doing. And it's quite good, actually. So you will see that entire explanation. What's also really interesting is that I think for not knowing Unity, not knowing scripting, etc., that in the past couple of minutes, we managed to build a small game in Unity with Rider, with the AI Assistant, and that's pretty cool, I would say. I don't think the code that we wrote here will win any awards, and I think experienced Unity developers will probably be angry and frown at me for setting up the entire scene in code instead of in the editor, but I do think being able to explore and learn with the help of the AI Assistant is quite interesting and quite helpful. So I would say give this all a try. Links to the relevant resources are in the video description below, and thank you for watching.